Hi, welcome to Coding Droplets. In this video, we are going to see about two important things of Docker, Dockerfile and Docker Compose. We'll be using both Dockerfile and Docker Compose while developing the projects in our upcoming videos. So let's get started. First, let's see about Dockerfile. What is a Dockerfile? Docker can build images automatically by reading the instructions from a Docker file. A Docker file is a text document that contains all the commands a user could call on the command line to assemble an image. So, we can create a Docker file and use Docker build command to create an image from the Docker file. Then we can use Docker run command to create and run a Docker container from the Docker image. Now let's have a look on some of the Docker files. You can view the Docker files by clicking on the tags provided in the Docker image documentation in Docker Hub. Let me open the official image of Redis. In the documentation, you can see there are several tags available. Let me click on this version with Alpine operating system. Here you can see the Docker file for that tag in GitHub. There are several instructions mentioned in the Docker file, like from, run, env, etc. The instructions are not case sensitive. However, the convention is for them to be uppercase to distinguish them from the arguments more easily. Docker treats lines that begin with hash as a comment, unless the line is a valid parser directive. We'll be discussing about parser directives in a later session. Docker runs instructions in a Docker file in order. A Docker file must begin with a from instruction. On the top, it is mentioned from Alpine 3.15. So Alpine colon 3.15 is a different image. Means this Redis Docker image is using the Docker image of Alpine and running some commands in it to download and install Redis and run it. Now let's have a look on the Alpine's Docker image. So let me search for Alpine here. Here you can see the official image of Alpine. Let me click on that. So in this Docker image documentation, you can see some tags here. 3.15, 3.14, 3.13, several versions. So let me click on the latest version to see the Docker file. Here you can see the from instruction in the Docker file and the argument is scratch. So let's find out what is scratch. I'm searching for scratch Docker image. And here you can see the Docker image scratch, the official image. I'm clicking on that. So here you can see that the scratch image is the smallest possible image for Docker. It is an empty image. You can also see the details in the image documentation. So here there is a small example showing how to use the scratch image. Next, let's see some commonly used instructions in the Docker files. First one, from. This command allows you to create a base image such as an operating system, a programming language, etc. The instructions executed after this command take place on this base image. Second one, run, used to run specified commands. You can use several run instructions to run different commands. Third one, cmd, specifies the instruction that is to be executed when a Docker container starts. Fourth one, ENTRYPOINT, used to set executables that will always run when the container is initiated. Unlike cmd command, ENTRYPOINT commands cannot be ignored or overwritten. Fifth one, WORKDIR, to specify your working directory inside the container. Sixth one, COPY, to copy files or folder from your local machine to the Docker container. Seventh one, ADD, similar to COPY instruction, you can use ADD instruction to copy files or folders from your local machine to the Docker container. However, ADD instruction also allows you to copy files from a URL or a tar file. Expose. The expose instruction inside the Docker file informs that the container is listening to the specified port in the network. The default protocol is TCP. Label to add description or metadata for a Docker image. It's a key value pair. The 10th one is volume, used to create or mount a volume to the Docker container from the Docker host file system. Next is user, used to set the username, group name, UID or GID for running subsequent commands. If not provided, the root user will be used. Next one, env, used to set environment variables with key and value. Next one, ARG, also used to set environment variables with key and value, but this variable will set only during the image build, not on the container. And next one is onBuild, used to specify the commands that runs when the new Docker image is used as a base image for another image. Now let's create a Docker image from a Docker file. I have already created a Docker file which is having three different instructions. It is having a from instruction to use Alpine as the base image. Then I have provided a copy instruction to copy the folder named sample files. Let's see what we have in the sample files folder. Here you can see there are three text files, and I need to copy these three files to the container. Finally, I have given a command to sleep for 2 minutes for just keeping the container running for 2 minutes. Otherwise, the container will get stopped immediately. So we are not running any other services. If there are no services running, then the container will get stopped. So I have opened PowerShell to execute the Docker build command. As I told in the previous video, you can use PowerShell or command prompt in Windows. If you are using Mac or Linux, you can use the terminal. So let me provide Docker build command, then hyphen T, which is a parameter for assigning a name for the image. So I'm providing sample-img as the image name. We can also provide the tag along with the image name by separating with a colon. You can specify a version number if needed. If not provided anything, Docker will automatically assign a latest tag for the image. After that, we can provide hyphen F parameter, which is used to mention the Docker file name. But we don't really need to provide this parameter as we have used the default Docker file name, that is just Dockerfile. So I'm just removing the hyphen F parameter. So if you are using a different file name, you can provide hyphen F, then the file name here. So now currently we are using the default Docker file name. We are not providing this parameter. Then finally, just provide a dot, then hit enter. Now the Alpine latest OS is getting downloaded. And finally, the image got created. Now I can see the image using Docker images command. And you can see here, the image name is sample img. The tag is latest. So as we have not provided a custom tag, automatically Docker used latest tag. Then the image ID, which is a unique ID for the image in our machine. Also, it is showing the image size. I can open Docker desktop and choose the images option to see the image details. Here also you can see the image name, tag, image ID, then size, all those details. Now let's provide the Docker run command to create container from this image, and it will run the container. So we have to provide the image ID as well. And now if I open Docker desktop, I can see that the container got created and it is running. So from the Docker desktop, we can open the CLI of this container. So otherwise from the terminal, you can just provide docker exec hyphen it, then the image ID slash bin slash sh, that will open the same terminal or the same command line for the Docker. Now here, I'm just providing ls command, and you can see here there is a folder named my files. I'm just providing cd my files to go inside the folder and providing the ls command. And here you can see we have all the three text files which we had in our sample files folder. So the files got copied to the container. So next, let's move to Docker Compose. What is Docker Compose? Docker Compose is a tool to help define and share multi-container applications. It's an important tool for any application that needs multiple microservices, as it allows each service to easily be in a separately managed container. How to use Docker Compose? We can use a YAML file to configure your application's services. The configuration for a Docker Compose file is done in docker-compose.yml. You don't need to place this file at the root of your project like a Docker file. In fact, it can go anywhere as it doesn't depend on any other code. However, if you are building the images locally, it will need to go in a project folder with the code being built. Next, we are going to create multi-service containers using Docker Compose. So in my C folder, I have created a Docker Compose file, docker-compose.yml. This is the content of the Docker Compose file. In the first line, you can see the version of the Docker Compose. So I'm using Docker Compose version 3.7. So in the first line of our Docker Compose file, we can mention the version of the Docker Compose which we are going to use. Next, I have mentioned a volume, wp-data. After that, networks, wp-network. After that, you can see there are several services. The first service is DB. So I have provided a custom name for the container, mysql-db. And the image which I am going to use is mysql:5.7. So 5.7 is the version which I am going to use. Then I have mentioned volume for the MySQL container. After that, I have mentioned the environment variables. It contains MySQL root password, MySQL database name, MySQL user, MySQL password. Then the port number for MySQL. So normally it uses 3306, but I have provided a custom port number, 8889. And finally, I have assigned wp-network for this container. Next service is phpMyAdmin. I have provided php-myadmin as the container name and the base image phpMyAdmin/phpMyAdmin. And here you can see it is depending on the DB container. After that, I have provided the environment variables for this particular container. Then the port number, I have assigned 8001. After that, I have provided the same network name. Then the final service, that is WordPress, container name is WordPress-site. Image is WordPress:latest, so it will pull the latest version of WordPress. And this container also depends on the DB container. And provided a custom port number for WordPress 8002, then the environment variables for the container and volume and network. Now let's execute the command for creating the containers for this particular services. So I'm providing docker-compose space up, then -d to detach the containers, and that's enough. Now Docker Compose will pull the images from the repository and create the containers. So initially it is pulling the MySQL image, and pulling that image got completed. Now it is going to pull phpMyAdmin, and that also completed. Now the next image is for WordPress, the final image. So all the images got downloaded successfully and the containers are created. Now the containers are running. So I can use docker images command to see all the images. And you can see we have WordPress, MySQL, and phpMyAdmin. Now let me provide docker ps command to see the running containers. And you can see all the three containers are running. Now I have opened Docker desktop, and you can see here demo WordPress. This is the application. And if I click on this expand button, it will show the containers running inside it. So MySQL, WordPress, and phpMyAdmin all are running fine. And here you can also see the port numbers each container is listening to. The first DB container is listening to 8889, WordPress listening to 8002, phpMyAdmin listening to 8001. So let's try to open the URLs localhost colon 8001, and that is the phpMyAdmin, and you can see that phpMyAdmin is working fine. Now let me try to open localhost 8002, and you can see now WordPress is also working fine. So here we have got the initial setup page for WordPress. So that's it for this video. Hope you liked it. Please subscribe, like, and share this video. See you all in the next video. Thank you.